Welcome back, everyone, and it's time to go balls deep. I know it's been a while since we posted any God of High School content, and with the Tower of God anime finished, we haven't been giving much love to the manga and webcomic scene, especially since I've been telling you guys that the anime community needs to recognize the untapped potential of Korean and Chinese webcomic. With Solo Leveling and Tower of God, God of High School is amongst the favorites for many readers. And with the recent release of the God of High School anime, what better time to start doing God of High School content? But that all depends on you guys. If you want us to do this type of content, then share this video with all your friends and make sure to smash that like button along with getting to the end of the video to show that you guys are actually interested. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down the basic concept of the power system of Charyeok in God of High School for anyone who just started this series, along with going over some lore in this crazy universe. Before I begin, if it wasn't obvious, this might have some slight spoilers, not too much, so you can watch it even if you don't read the manga or manhwa. And also, please know, I'm going to be butchering these pronunciations. Right off the bat, God of High School is set in modern day Korea, although the world building is pretty inclusive of other major influential countries such as the USA. However, in this universe, the myth and legend found in the Handan Gogi, which is a compilation of texts on ancient Korean history, is a huge inspiration for the lore of the God of High School universe. Now, there is many other inspiration for the series from the Journey to the West, including other folklores and ancient fables. But in the God of High School universe, a long time ago, even before land and civilization on Earth began forming, the world was shared amongst humans, monsters, and gods. Yes, you heard that right. There are monsters and gods besides humans. But back in the days, the monsters wanted to rule over the humans as they themselves were far stronger, whereas humans were the weakest amongst the free. We are talking about time before technology, so there ain't no AK-47s or any nukes. This is the Stone Age, and there ain't no Senku from Dr. Stone to help these humans out. And in those times, mankind was scattered and divided into their own clans, only fending for themselves. Eventually, after a great war broke out between the humans and monsters, a chieftess of a human clan named Ongi Nyuyu Ogi.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
But this dude, however his name is pronounced, knowing that the humans on the defensive were about to lose, appealed to the distant gods to lend them their power. After much deliberation, they agreed to directly infuse their godly power into the humans, and thus the original way of Charyeok, or also known as power borrowing, was born. And this ultimately gave the humans the power to defeat the monsters. Now the thing here is that the initial method of power borrowing was so potent to the point of almost being on par with the gods. However, this power came at a great cost, as it had to be linked to the user's life force, which caused some drastic effect to the user's age, either randomly increasing it or decreasing it rapidly. So basically, they were only able to use this OP power temporarily, and after the user used it, they would either rapidly age, hastening their death, and at such fragile state, they wouldn't even be able to use this power anymore. Likewise, the ones who age regressed would also turn to a fragile state, in this case a child, where the can't use this power again effectively until they grow up. If you look at it, this is a contract between humans and gods, and it has a price being the lifespan of the user. Because in this universe, nothing is free, and the gods are not immortal themselves. In a way, I guess they are also benefiting from this trade-off. Although regressing the age of a person could also be seen as giving life, but I'm sure there's an explanation to this on how the gods actually benefit. By the way guys, around this time, there was also another prominent clan who the gods gave the power to, but after seeing the cost of using such power, they deemed it wasn't worth it. So they refused this power and sought to create their own form of power, thus the creation of martial arts. Yes, in the God of High School universe, martial arts is an ancient practice indirectly created by the conflicts between the humans and monsters. But coming back to the power of Charyeok, after the ancient war between the monsters and humans finally ended, Hanong, who was one of the gods, fell in love with a human. And because he didn't want his unborn child to experience the burden of the original power power borrowing system, he decided to destroy it. Yeah, man's like, you know what, if it doesn't work for me and my child, I ain't having it. The destruction of this original system caused the godly power to be distributed amongst the humans without restriction and cost, meaning that although the power was diluted, it wouldn't bring an adverse effect to the user's age. This is the current power borrowing system used in the series. It's much weaker, but is safer to use. Just a quick note, it's indicated that this new system of Charyeok was spreaded by Hanong's child to create a better world for the humanity to live in. In a lot of ways, this Kami was like Hagoromo Otsutsuki from Naruto, and his son was like Asura Otsutsuki. But because of this god's actions in destroying the original power borrowing system, the other gods got pissed off and punished him. And in fear that the humans using this new system would get strong enough to eventually rival them, like since they're essentially the same but with just longer lifespan, the gods placed a taboo on the humans, where they were unable to harm or kill the gods. However, there are ways to break this taboo, which allows the user to revert back to using the original method of power borrowing. But all in all, essentially, Charyeok is when someone makes a contract with a supernatural entity in which the contractor is able to borrow their power. A side note is that the borrowed source can also be demons and human ghosts, not just literal gods. I've been using gods throughout this because that's where it originally stemmed from. So now you guys kind of got the gist of the lore of God of High School, but you guys might be asking, anime balls deep, how does this power borrowing system actually even work? Is this some divine possession or something? What is this shit? Well, through the user's imagination and empathy, they can shape the power that is given to them through the deity. Think along the lines of Shaman King, Amidomaru, into the sword, and the stands from Jojo. To use Charyeok, or divine power, the person has to use their own life and biological energy. The color of the energy is known to appear as violet. Now, even though this current system doesn't have crazy drawbacks like its prototype, it still has its limitations, where if someone continues to use the Charyeok for too long, it can cause intense fatigue and other physical complications. Even so much as injuring in their finger can cause them to become incapacitated and can pretty much halt the user from using their borrowed power. In some way, it's kind of like using too much chakra in Naruto or quirks in My Hero Academia. Okay, I don't know if that's a good comparison, but I try. Now, throughout God of High School, we see that most characters have reached a level where they can materialize distinct living entities using the Charyeok, but every entity is not the same, as it will appear and take form depending on the user's imagination and personality, as well as their own strength and energy. Initially, the strength of Charyeok is measured by God Points or GP, but like Dragon Ball Z, the power levels doesn't mean much later on in the series. Eventually, GP becomes irrelevant. And plus, it's not the size of the GP that matters, it's the way you use it. But there is much more to learn about how Charyeok works. For instance, there are multiple ways to exhibit and use Charyeok, which are split into 6 classes, one of them being weapon summoning and reinforcement. Now, the name pretty much gives it away, as the person who's using Charyeok can manifest it as a force to use as their weapon, or they can use Charyeok to support the current weapon. In some ways, you can think of it as Green Lantern's ability, where he can create things out of his own imagination. But in this case, the Charyeok can create actual legendary weapons and shield. And honestly, some of these guys can even bring up some ancient mythological weapons. But moving on to the next class of Charyeok, and that would be summoning. Now, this is when the user manifests their own Charyeok as a specific entity or item, which is then under their control. These entities or items can be equipped and can even change the person's appearance and amplify their natural skills and abilities. Yes, this class of Charyeok can even be more useful, as the user can then choose to make it invisible to everyone else unless they decide to reveal it. Pretty broken if you ask me. The next class, in my opinion, is the most mysterious one. It's called the parasitic type. This type presents itself as an entity that exists on part of the user's body. The more the person uses it, the more powerful it will grow and spread. As of now, it's not really known what will happen if it completely spreads and covers the Charyeok user, but it is suspected that either the user will completely be engulfed by the entity, or they will gain vast power beyond our comprehension. Who knows? This might be an attempt of possession. Next up is the Charyeok class known as Direct Contract, and it is exactly as the title infers. The user of the Direct Contract is personally infused with the power given by the Kami. This is usually by contacting them within their own realm. The Direct Contract Charyeok also lets the user efficiently communicate with the god who gave them that power. And in some ways, this is actually the next level up from the current Charyeok system that is used. Another Charyeok class out there is the power lenderization or the lineal descendant. This is actually just a more advanced level of the Charyeok class direct contract. This one is actually pretty sick as it allows the individual receiving the power to take on the form and become an actual avatar of the god itself. Yeah, we're talking about full on avatar mode with your head glowing out and shit. No, but seriously, it will give the user complete access to the full range of the god's power. However, this is a limited Charyeok class as it's only possible for the lineal descendant of that god to receive their power. So basically, you have to be the descendant of this kami, and I don't know how likely are you to be one of them. Obviously, this one did seem just a bit too OP to give to anyone. Lastly, one of the most powerful type of Charyeok is known as ki. It is actually rare for a user to possess this Charyeok, as ki can awake and seal abilities in mortals and kami alike, appropriately described as the existence that will drag the gods from the heavens. The ability to use this Charyeok actually comes from a darker place of incredible hatred and wrath. The power can only be channeled from a powerful being considered to be a god or deity that opposes the gods of the heavens, wanting to seek vengeance against them. The hatred itself makes this particular Charyeok powerful. Lastly, the most powerful Charyeok is the original power borrowing, which I mentioned earlier. This type is only accessed when the taboo is broken, which can only be done when a user has the ki Charyeok. Remember, ki can seal any ability even belonging to a god. Now, a lot of these types of Charyeok will be confusing for you lot until you see it in action. I try to keep it brief, but this is where I would recommend you guys in joining me in the Twitch live stream I do every week, where sometimes I'm reading the God of High School manga and you can be part of that discussion. Also, make sure to keep up to date with the anime so you guys can let me know if you want me to do more God of High School content. I'm thinking to do a list on the strongest God of High School fighters. If you want that, then you know what to do. Smash that like button, join our Discord, subscribe, and till then, I'll catch you lot next time.